for prevention of diabetes, the best thing is to make sure you're at a healthy weight. You want to eat healthy foods, and really keep seeing your primary care doctor to make sure that you are staying healthy so that they can do routine monitoring of your blood, and keeping you accountable for your healthy weight and healthy lifestyle. So a pre-diabetic basically means that a patient is, their blood sugar is somewhat high. Sometimes it's high, sometimes it's not. It kind of fluctuates between a normal range. A lot of times it depends on what they have eaten. If they've eaten really high sugary foods or high in carbohydrates, their blood sugar will probably likely be a lot higher than, say, a normal person's blood sugar after that meal. But yet it's not so high that it's causing problems yet. Diabetes will affect your kidneys, will affect your heart, whereas pre-diabetes, you might be on the road to that, but not quite there. And that's there, at pre-diabetes and before is really where we would like to catch our patients. If you are a pre-diabetic, you can definitely change your lifestyle and get out of that category. A lot of times it has to do with just changing your lifestyle, changing your eating habits and changing your exercise habits, or start exercising. Possibly just losing a few pounds will be enough to get you out of that range of pre-diabetes. There are a few different ways that we can screen for and diagnose diabetes. The most common one is a hemoglobin A1C. This is a blood test that can be performed that will kind of give us an average of what a patient's blood sugar has been doing over a 3 to 4 month time period. We do use it for screening as well. Sometimes we'll see that a patient is borderline or pre-diabetic, and we can start to take more intensive preventative actions to help prevent that patient from going on to become diabetic. Risk factors for diabetes would include if you have a family history of diabetes. Also, if you are overweight, you are more likely to become diabetic. If you have a poor diet, if you eat high sugary foods or high carbohydrate foods, you're going to be more likely to become diabetic as well. Other risk factors for diabetes, Hispanic is definitely a race factor that you are more predisposed to diabetes, as well as being a Pacific Islander or Native Alaskan. They are also at higher risk for diabetes, as well as a Native American.